I don't think it's very useful to think in terms of competition between languages. Often people grow up with one. People grow up with at least one language, sometimes more languages. And when we think of them, when a person thinks of adopting or learning another language, usually because they're told or asked if they want to do that at school, often it's English, but it can be Chinese as well. We don't see very many systems around the world adopting Chinese as a second language, maybe some. We can expect, obviously, as the economy around a language grows, then that language will naturally become more important. And I guess we can expect that with Chinese, with a huge growing economy. I guess another thing to think about in that context is if you look at ASEAN, the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, that group of Asian nations has adopted English as their official lingua franca, the language that they speak to each other in officially. And that's close to China. And indeed, the Chinese themselves are famously very keen on learning English. I'd certainly like my children, my grandchildren, to learn Chinese as well as English. It is a language of the future, but not in a competing sense, I think.